God, dear ones, is beyond your understanding. It is beyond your mind. But God is within your experience in every moment. You are God. All of life is God. There is no hierarchy in creation. There is only oneness. The belief of hierarchy is a belief in your mind, believing that someone is greater than you, that someone has more power than you, when in truth, there is only one. One consciousness creating all things, one consciousness existing as all things. We cannot know it, but we can be it. We cannot think it, but we experience it. And nothing we will ever think will ever change the reality that we are this. And so, dear ones, spirituality is awakening. Awakening to that which has always been. Awakening to that which you have always been and which you are in every moment. Spirituality is the understanding of truth, not ideas of truth, not beliefs of what we say is true and what is false. Truth, dear ones, genuine truth, that which cannot be destroyed, that which does not change. And that is simply this. That is simply the reality that all of manifestation is change. And that there is a changeless, formless consciousness that exists amidst the change, beyond the change, with the change. For it is the changing and the changeless. It is that which appears to be impermanent and that which appears to be permanent that give itself experience. We cannot know the permanence without the impermanence. And vice versa. Both are codependent upon each other. And this is how creation exists. We are both. We are all. And we are greater than this moment in manifestation. But we are that which will exist beyond the forms. We are at that which does exist beyond the forms. We are that which exists as the forms, as the force creating the forms. We are all of this. And only the act of surrendering to this moment, of surrendering to God, to the universe, to whatever name you may put upon it, it is only the act of surrendering into the silence of being that will give you freedom. And so, dear ones, you are sensitive, for you are the act of perception, and it is not the sensitivity that causes you suffering. It is, dear one, your resistance to what is happening, for your mind says, they should not act this way towards me. I should not feel this way in myself. It is wrong that they do this. Why do they hurt me so? Why do I feel their emotions? Why do I feel their mind? Why do I feel their actions? Why do I feel my pain? Why do I feel my past? It is all of these questions and all of these doubts, all of these judgments and all of these complaints that you project upon this moment to create your own experience. And then you look to justify them. Your mind looks to uphold this illusion and say, it is real. I must find information to support that which I see as my truth. But, dear ones, it is all changing. And it is your projection that you have the power to create and that you have the power to destroy. And so, dear ones, what do you hold to be truth in your mind? Are you afraid to let go? Are you afraid to believe nothing? Are you afraid to be no one? Are you afraid to be free? To be free of a personality? To be free of how others see you? To be free of how you think about yourself. Are you, dear ones? Are you ready to be free? For you hold within your hand that which is creating your limitation, and it is your fear to release it that is keeping you bound. There is no force holding this over you. It is your choice, dear ones, of that which you believe to be true. It is your choice of how you wish to behave, of how you wish to perceive and think about this world. It is your choice, dear ones. So look and ask yourself, what are you creating? What would you like to experience? For that is the role of being in manifestation. You have the freedom to create your experience as you desire. Experience is not given to you, but coming from you. For you keep your perception upon this world and experience it. And when you close your eyes and fall asleep, you allow yourself to surrender this world. And you may appear in dreams. You may appear in otherly world, other dimensions of reality. It is where you place your focus that determines what you experience. It is your degree of mastery over the control of your focus that determines your ability to create new awareness. And so, dear one, it all lies within you. You are creating this moment. You are creating your perception of this moment. For you can close your eyes and your vision ceases to be. You can withdraw the pranic flow of energy from your vision back to its core in your heart, and vision will disappear. The feeling of being in this room will disappear. The feeling of being alive as a human being will disappear when you withdraw your sense energy into yourself, into the heart. You, dear one, will enter a samadhi state, a state of otherworldly reality, in which there is simply oneness of being, in which the world disappears and yet you still are. This is a choice of if you wish to give yourself it, a choice of you if you wish to devote yourself to it. For existing within you, dear one, is pattern of behavior, pattern of how the past is carried forth into the future. It is this pattern that must be changed. It is not that life is preventing you from something. It is that your pattern is restricting what is possible in this moment, because you are still reinforcing the pattern within. And so surrender it here and now, and it will die off in time. And stay focused upon that which you wish to create, and the power of your own intention will bring forth this experience more quickly. So have patience. Do not doubt the process of creation, but instead understand your role within it. With this, dear one, you will not gain unrealistic hopes. You will not fall for sales pitches coming from the spiritual marketplace of this world. You will not believe that if you take a weekend course, you will buy your enlightenment. You will not believe that if you take a weekend course, you will be reborn.